So I'm back here with AJ Wood, and we're going to be talking about the Albion. So give us a bit of an update on where we are with squad numbers.
Bizarre. Well, yeah, there's
McAllister's got number 10.
Been an update, yeah. So the there's been three added squad numbers to the list. McAllister, number 10. I was a bit surprised with that. Straight away, being given a big jersey. Funnily enough, it was Andone's shirt number last year. He's kind of fallen down the pecking order a little bit, and I don't think he ever wants to play for Brighton again, from what I've heard. So. That's left open for him. A big pressure for him. Only youngster coming in, never played a game in England, never played a game in Europe. All of a sudden, given the number 10 in a Premier League.
But he's in the Argentinian under-23s, though.
Yeah, he is, but it's a bit of a step. It's a bit of a step. Yeah. He's also played Argentina first team.
Yeah, he's been doing well over there, hasn't he?
Yeah,
because they've got an under-23s.
Yeah, they've just finished that competition. So he's got a week break, and then he joins up with the squad when they come back from Tenerife.
Yeah.
Lamptey, surprisingly enough, has been given the number 2 jersey.
Yeah.
Which was Bruno's old number.
Yeah.
But it's, again, a Lamptey, it's a youngster, just in his teens, has come straight in and been given a big number in the squad. It shows Potter's looking to use both of these players a lot, I think.
In the remaining 12 games.
Well, I think you give him that number. I don't think it's just the remaining 12 games. I think it's looking further to the future as well, yeah. And then also, Behram Kayal's come back from, he was at Charlton first half of the season. Picked up an injury, but I think he can be a useful player for us, especially with Stevens out injured or another midfielder missing. Yeah. You've got Kayal, who can be that holding midfielder, who can be a little bit tenacious in there and pick it up. He's been given the number 25, which is surprising as well.
So, Brighton, we're going to assume they're going to be staying up.
Yeah.
We're very positive.
We are.
Who's going to be joining Brighton in the Premier League next season from the Championship then? Because that's hotting up down there.
It's a really tough league.
Falling away again.
We don't like using that song. But.
So we've got Leeds and Forest, two former Premier League clubs. I'm always amazed that they're in the Championship.
Well, yeah, there's
Forest haven't been there for a while, have they?
It's such a tough league. You look at Fulham. Fulham have got Mitrovic still up front. They've got Kearney, Knocker, all these hugely talented players. And they're in third.
Yeah.
They're up there. But you think that with all those players, you think it's going to be tough for teams to play against them.
Yeah.
But West Brom seem to me like the team that are going to go away with it. They're often tends to be a team that kind of drifts away from the pack because it's so competitive league and it's such a difficult league to get up. It's almost a difficult time to even judge who's going to go up, who's going to go down.
Yeah.
But for me, West Brom, but Leeds again. I think Leeds every year. Leeds get to December, January, and everyone's like, "Well, they're home and hosed." And then they've won one in the last six, and even that game was they were 2-0 down at home to Millwall, pulled it back to 3-2. It was a remarkable comeback. But it was there's a pack of six teams in there. I think West Brom, as I said, are fine. I think you've got Leeds, you've got your pick between Leeds, Brentford, Fulham and Forest.
Yeah.
And none of them are looking like they're going to drop off. All right, Forest lost this week at home to Charlton, which was a big result for Charlton, especially in a huge defeat for Notts Forest.